An F-14 Tomcat piloted by Lieutenant Devon Jones was shot down on January 21st over the barren desert of Iraq.
Once you've got a guy on the ground, you know he's there and you know he's alive, it's time to change the plans and do whatever it takes to make sure you can get at him.
Captain Trask and his crew flew many hours in broad daylight in their search for the stranded Navy pilot.
And the hard part was he was now so far north that we were going to have to cross the major highways that run east-west from Baghdad over toward Jordan. And these were our biggest threats in the whole theater, was to cross those roads because they were heavily traveled with military vehicles in the middle of the daytime. We were painted brown camouflage and just hoped we were far enough away they really wouldn't realize that we were bad guys. And we got across there okay. From there, the A-10s started talking on the radios again, and then they started vectoring us to where they knew he was at. And the A-10s actually told us when to start flaring to land, because we still didn't know where the guy was. Well, it was about the time we were in the middle of our flare when vehicle rolled up.
An Iraqi truck came in from our 11 o'clock position, and I called him out about the same time the A-10 pilot called him out on the radio, and Major Homan, the co-pilot, told him to smoke the truck.
We immediately made a break away from the truck, and the A-10s immediately rolled in on it. And all we did was make one big loop and turn back toward it. By the time we got turned back to the truck, it was just a big smoking hole. A 30-millimeter cannon on an A-10 is going to take out a truck every time. But the truck actually rolled up to within 50 or 100 yards of where Lieutenant Jones had dug his hole in the desert, and it was coming straight at him. We made a real quick stop landing, rolled up right next to him. A pararescueman jumped out of the back, ran him, grabbed him by the flight suit, pulled him on board. We were on the ground about 20 seconds, and we pulled pitch and turned back south to get out of there.
It was a great, great, great feeling. I mean, we still had to get out of Iraq, and that was just secondary, knowing that we had picked him up and he was safe inside and we were going to get him out of there.
He came up to the cockpit and stuck his head in there, a big grin on his face, and patted everybody on the shoulder. That was a pretty good feeling.
I was glad to be a part of it. We all were proud. I mean, we got one of our guys back.
That we did paid off, and we did it right. We got in there and we got Lieutenant Jones out, and we didn't get shot down, nobody got hurt, and we pulled it off. It was a pretty great feeling.